I'm starting on another filament changer build. I promise you I am going to finish the 3MS, but I have an opportunity to help beta test the LDO kit for the box turtle. I'm not going to talk much about the kit right now because it is still in beta testing, so some things are going to change. I can talk about that once I'm done, and I will probably go back and build one of the production units as well. So far, everything is looking pretty good. LDO puts a lot of work into making their kits the highest quality they can. So by the time we get through beta and this goes into production, I'm sure the kit is going to be fantastic. But let's take a step back and talk about what the Box Turtle actually is. It is an open source filament changer that will work with any printer that runs mainstream Clipper. So as long as you can make changes to the firmware in your Clipper printer, you can install this and have four different spools of filament ready to go for your multi-color or multi-material prints. There are a lot of filament changers available in the open source community. What makes this one so different is that it has an automated respooler. So rather than using a traditional buffer where you have to do a couple wraps of filament so that as filament is loaded and unloaded, it has some place to go, the Box Turtle automatically respools that filament for you. And I'll show you how that works in a moment. The design also incorporates some very unique features like this tiny motor with a tiny gearbox, which is what's used to drive the respooler. This will wind and unwind the filament as it's being used. The project also has its own custom MCU called the AFC Light. This is the AFC Light by Isix Tech. It can be run either through CAN or USB. The CAN connector also brings in 24 volts to power the Box Turtle. The Box Turtle has four extruders, so here are the ports for the extruder motors. This is where the 2209s to drive those will plug in. There are four RGB LED ports, a cooling fan port. There are 12 filament sensor switch inputs. This design uses a number of switch inputs so that it can tell where the filament is. Then there are these outputs for the respooler motors. I'm partway through the build. There are a number of components that you build multiple times because there are four lanes of filament. So you need to build four respoolers and four extruders and so on and so on. I have one lane partially built. So let's take a look at that and it'll help explain how the system works. So here's one tray or one lane of the Box Turtle. Obviously there would be four of these in the frame. So let's take a look at what the filament path is and how the system functions. So the filament comes off the spool here, goes into the system. This just passes through. This would be inside the unit. There's the top of the frame is right here. There's an RGB LED so that you can get feedback from the system as to which filament spool is currently being used. So the filament comes down here, and then there is an extruder here. You can see the extruder motor. Filament comes down, goes into the extruder, and then out. Filament then exits toward the back of the Box Turtle and goes into this PTFE combiner. So each lane of filament will go through here and then output to go to your printer. This feature is for a filament sensor switch. So the Box Turtle knows when filament has entered the extruder because there's a filament sensor switch there. There's another one at the combiner. So the system can see where the filament is loaded at multiple points. And if we look again at the front, these are wheels. This is a TPU printed feature so that as you are printing, these are going to turn, driven by one of those small motors. And that's going to help the extruder for this lane smoothly feed the filament to your printer. And then as it's changing, the extruder will pull the filament from your printer and these wheels will spin the other way to help the spool take up that slack. It's a well-designed system. The documentation is coming along really well. I really like the fact that the drawings of the parts are zoomable and panable through the web documentation. So it makes it very easy to see where you need to put in heat inserts and how things are lining up. I'm working my way through. I still have 3 respoolers to build. And then I need to start working on putting the frame together. And then the big part is the wiring and running all of the PTFE tube. And then eventually this is going to go live at the shop so that we can use it to do multicolor prints for some of our customer orders. I look forward to bringing you more on how the box turtle build is going soon. So if the box turtle sounds interesting to you, you can self-source it if you want, but we do have pre-sales open for the LDO box turtle kits, which should be shipping very soon. So head on over to West3D and you can pre-order your box turtle and start building your own automated filament changer as soon as they're available.